left off for Raviv. This is the Kabbalah. The person makes a commitment not to repeat it in the future. She Yoshiv Akzelos V'imonim in Averos. Person, let's say, steals. You have to return the stolen item. You have to return whatever you stole or. V'imonim in Averos. V'yeref Ma'azokos Kalabroid. And one has to cease damaging or harming other people. Moshkosu, Chavol Yoshiv Rosha of Zeli Yishali. He says, the wicked man returned the security and paid for what he stole. V'omar, im ovim biyotcho, person has something which is a iniquity in his hand. Harchikeu, you should separate yourself from it. Distance, Valtashka Bobecha Aflo. This is very important. Valtashka Bobecha Aflo. You will see. There's a minog. It's a term, you find this puzzle, what do they do? What do you do with the Sefer Torah till it's corrected? A mistake. On the outside. You put a darko on the outside. Why? It has to be identified. Because if it's not identified, there's a question of mistaking, you may use it. And if over, you're not permitted to keep a Sefer Torah which is puzzle over an extended period of time. With this concern that ultimately you may end up using it. Like the Gemara says, if you have a document which was paid, you're a lender. In the olden days, if you wanted the person would want to borrow money. Personally, I'm a lender. We have a written document. It has to be a written document. Otherwise, we don't want to have proof that I lent you. So you had to go to a scribe. It was a scribe's fee. Let's say the borrower, the lender, laid out the money for the scribe's fee. So he owes him more than the actual loan. He has to reimburse him for the fee that it cost him to write the document. When the borrower comes to pay, he says, I only have enough money to pay the debt. I can't pay. He says, I'll hold the document. It's a problem. Because if he holds the document, let's say he should die. His heirs will find this document, they're going to collect on that document again. It's a problem. Creates a problem. What should be if he should forget? We're not really so concerned about more the heirs. That if he should die and the document's found among his personal effects, they're going to collect again with the document. So you have to make some kind of indication on the document that that document was a paid document, right? Paid whatever you write on it. Or you give the man a receipt, which is also not so simple, because if you give him a receipt, what happens if he loses the receipt? Right? Because a person doesn't always keep a receipt. If they lose it, so it keeps creating problems. This is the posuk, Al Tashkin Ba'alecha Abla. Versus Sefer Torah, Sheikh Muga, Sefer Torah, which wasn't checked. Ki oz tiso ponecho mimum. Only then, when you cleanse your home from iniquity, from stolen goods, from anything which is not appropriate, only then are you able to lift up your face. You're no longer considered blemish. Hachamishi de libo gdula sabor yisaleh hashehim redvoro. Person should what? Take the heart, the exaltedness of the Creator, which he defied his word, and he removed himself from the bond of his avodo and the transmission of his Torah. The person should reprimand himself and feel ashamed because of his behavior. Moshe Nemar, Halashem Tign Luzos, Boma Osi Lo Tiro Genum Hashem. This proper baby, who do you think you are? Person has to speak. Think about himself in this manner. To feel the inappropriateness of the behavior, to feel shame, and if you have that sense of shame, you're not going to become a repeated offender. Just do the next paragraph. I will open ha'ora yil arba dvorim. Now, how does a person bring himself to a point where he feels he has to do tshuva? We know we're not perfect. How do you focus in a way that you're motivated to do tshuva? Like the Rambam, the Hilchos Tshuva, the first halacha of Hilchos Tshuva, he doesn't say chayav l'avos is tshuva. The Rambam says when a person does tshuva, this is the way you do it. It doesn't say the only time you're obligated to do tshuva is on Yom Kippur. only day that you're obligated to do tshuva. During the year, the Rambam says, kishiyasa tshuva. When you do tshuva, and he gives you the prescription, how exactly tshuva. But how do you bring yourself to that mindset to want to do tshuva, or feel the need to do tshuva? So that's what he said. Ha'ofen ha'ora yil arbo dvorim. Ha'echad michozek ha'kores ha'odem esalokov. Yeah, he says, it's on account of a person's profound understanding of God, and contemplating the continuous, unceasing goodness which comes upon him from him. As a result of that, you're obligated in his service and observing his commandments. And you have to, he says, abstain from what he prohibited. This point over here is missed by most of us. And then we say, why is it so important? The third part of the Shmona that says Modim and Nachum Lo. But we say Modim. What do you have to say Modim? I mean, without saying Modim, you have a chance to think and consider that you're beneficiary of all that Hashem has done for you. Right? Without that, whoever thinks that I'm healthy, I function, I'm able to be effective, I have to be thankful. I have no health issues. Who thinks about these things? You don't think about it. The main thing is the Amid, the Shmonesu is the main thing. You know, if you have the Shachim and say the Brocha, it's a tefillah's own different thing. The third component, part of Shmonesu, is crucial. Without that, who thinks about being thankful? We say we acknowledge him, he created the fruit of the tree. Okay? That's also, these brachas bring, hopefully, bring these things to mind. But otherwise,
you know, all the eight brachas.
No, they're not kashrus. You praise Hashem. No, it's requests.
Right, yeah.
They're all requests.
Yeah.
100%.
Yeah.
Modim's thanks. We're giving thanks to Hashem for what he did for us, what he provided for us. But even though we say it, do you feel thankful? When you say Modim, do you feel thankful? Most people know. We say words. We say Ezras before the Shmona Esrei. We enumerate things there that for one of them, we should praise God forever, be thankful. Somehow it doesn't resonate within us. We don't feel that thankfulness. But if a person would have that sense of thankfulness, what would you do? Right? Of course, you realize immediately, you know, your behavior is not appropriate. You're falling short of what you should be doing. That's even not that we didn't see. Even though it's a different text. Modim, Rabbona. Yeah, same idea. But the Modim. Yeah. To be continued.